Open the gates, open the gates, Jesus. Open the gates, open the gates of revival over every nation, because the harvest is ready. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Just because the Lord would have me do this, so for proper understanding, so that many are not led astray, and many will understand, you know, what the Lord is doing in the now, what the Lord is doing in this season. This is a prophetic groan, and this is an assignment or a mandate that the Lord has demanded that we do. Not just me, but every other truly prophetic women who are called of the Lord, who are chosen for the Lord. Prophets, intercessors, warriors, every woman who is prophetic in the body of Christ, the remnants. This is a call to us all. The Lord wants us to groan for the nations. The Lord wants us to groan for the nations. The Lord wants us to groan right now. Karabayanti. There are different types of prayers. The Lord has been taking me through and be dealing with me and taking me through all sorts in this wilderness. And just 2 weeks ago, he breathed the groan and he said, the level I'm taking you to right now and the level I want you to operate because of the assignment, because of the sensitivity of the time and the demands, because of the nature, is a groan prayer. So I don't need you praying limited because of your words and what your mind can perceive and what your mind knows, because that is limited. I want you praying now with my spirit and by my spirit, doing the groaning, doing the praying with you and through you for the nations, because a lot is about to be unleashed. Hear with your spiritual ears and see with your spiritual eyes. A lot is going on in the spirit. There's a lot of warfare, massive, huge, I don't know how to describe it, but the warfare has never been this loud and intense. Has never been this loud and intense. And it is written in the word, that in the last days, iniquity will abound. Sin will increase. Wickedness will increase. The Lord allows that because the enemy knows that his days and his time is short. So it's a time that the Lord has allowed for darkness to have his way before he takes over. But there's something, you know, it is said that when you give a person a mile, they want to take 2 miles. You understand? So what the Lord has allowed for the enemy to do is what he would do. But the enemy would want to go contrarily, would want to go beyond what the Lord has said, and he cannot. So the Lord is saying to his church and to the women, especially the prophets, Makara Bayanti. Because you are trained for warfare. That I want you to arise as the watchman and groan over the nations to stop the feet of the enemy and put them back in their boundary. Put them back in their boundary. To put them back in their boundary. They will not exceed that which the Lord has allowed them to do. A lot of evil is being unleashed and is about to be unleashed on the earth. And the Lord is looking for women who would cry out. Women whom he would, as a conduit, you know, flow through to release its power over the earth. That when we stand and groan by the Holy Ghost, because he has given us influence in the spirit and influence in the natural. Whatever we groan and intercede and cry for, the Lord will establish. That is the reason for this. That is the purpose for the prophetic groan. This is necessary so that many don't be led astray and many don't put their mouth on what they don't understand. This is for prophetic people, prophetic women in the body of Christ. Jesus gave 5 gifts to the church, to his church: apostles, the sent ones, missionaries, prophets, evangelists, teachers, and pastors, to build up the saints for the work of the ministry, to perfect the body, to unite the body, to keep the body together and standing for the Lord. I want to tell you that the times ahead of us, they are perilous times, they are trying times, they are difficult times, they are hard times. Only those who are walking with the Holy Spirit, Only those who are humble, only those who are truly broken, who truly know the Lord and love the Lord, and are obedient to the Lord, only those who are the sons of God, because they are led by the Holy Ghost, only those, will survive it. Only those will be preserved. Only those will be secure. So this is a call out to everyone, every true believer. And the first one is a time for you to repent. Because a lot of evil is about to be unleashed on the earth, and the Lord will permit those he will permit. He will permit those he would permit. Many are going to die. Many are going to fall away. Many are going to... A lot of evil is about to befall the earth. And the Lord is saying, my church stand. My remnant arise. This is the time of the remnant. Harabayante. This is the time of the remnant. Those who are truly for Jesus. Those who are truly chosen of the Lord. The army of the Lord. The warriors. The end time warriors. This is your call. So this is what the prophetic groan is about. The Lord said, I want you to groan right now. Because the warfare is intense. So you need to intensify your fire. And the only thing that can give you that elevation is the groaning capacity. So this is what this is about. When we come here, we're not coming to pray by our mind, about what we know. We're coming to pray by the Spirit, what we don't see. Because the things that are seen are temporal. But the unseen things are eternal. So the Holy Ghost leads us to groan. He leads us to pray. Concerning those things that we see not and we know not. But the will of the Father. Because he alone searches the deep things in the heart of the Father. And he knows that which is the will of the Father. And he's able to pray through you and I. As his conduits. If we'll be submitted. Hallelujah. So that is what we are doing. So if you know that you are called and chosen of the Lord, and you have the prophetic anointing on your life, connect with me, women, connect with me, the body of Christ, connect with me and let us grow for nations. The enemy wants to take over the nation, wants to take over the government, to persecute the church massively. Yes, to an extent, the Lord will allow. But the one the Lord says no, he says, stand up and groan for me. Stand up and groan for me. He said, I want to groan now myself through you. I want to groan my shedding of Osiah. That I am God. And that my power will be seen on the earth again. And the enemy displays and put in his place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I want to urge you, if you know you are chosen, you are called, and you are anointed in that area, join me in the prophetic groan. And let the Holy Ghost groan through you and I for the nations, that the Lord will save the nations, that the Lord will save the government, Karadabayanti, to dethrone satanic governments and enthrone Masharamayanti, Horabayanti, righteousness in the name of Jesus, Karabayanti. Oh, the enemy is fighting tirelessly, Karabayanti, to silence the voice of the gospel, Karabayanti. But that is something they cannot do. Because the kingdom of God is not in word, but in power. Hallelujah. Oh, and God is sovereign. And whether they like it or not, he will always have his way. Oh, his way will always be established. But he needs his sons to arise. He needs his daughters to arise. He needs those he has anointed to walk, Karabayanti, to arise. And begin to grow for the nations. And when we groan in our groan, his power will be moved, released all over the earth. And he will intercept the satanic onslaught. Hallelujah. Remember, he always causes us to triumph in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you the praise. We thank you for the privilege, the honor, to be your sense in the light, to be chosen and anointed of you, Father, even to carry out this course for your kingdom. Oh, Ramashanda, we are grateful. And we thank you because we are your empowered army and house already. We already have the victory, we have the grace already to groan and take the gates, take charge, possess the gates of the nations. And whatsoever we cry, whatsoever we decree, as your watchman, Lord, you're bound to establish it because it is your word in the name of Jesus. So welcome on board and join me as we groan with the Lord together, that his kingdom be established on earth, in our lives, in the hearts of men, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless you.